In the year 1990, NASA launched the most powerful telescope ever developed into space, the Hubble Space Telescope. They didn't know it at the time, but this telescope was going to cause a massive shift in how scientists looked at our universe. For the first time in the history of our species, we were able to see deeper into space than ever before. What astronomers believed were empty areas in the sky turned out to be filled with millions upon millions of galaxies when Hubble took a long look into the void. By focusing Hubble's lenses on a small area of the sky at once, astronomers are able to get incredibly detailed and surreal images of the cosmos and all the mystical objects that inhabit it with us.
You could point it somewhere random, and you would see stars and galaxies and objects out there that had never been seen before.
This year has been another great year for the Hubble Telescope. Here is a recap of some of the best photos shot this year. In the sky with diamonds. In this picture, we can see the aftermath of two doomed stars that are located nearly 15,000 light-years away. This nebula is known as the Necklace Nebula and is part of the constellation Sagitta, which is the arrow. This nebula was produced by two stars that were roughly the size of the Sun, orbiting each other tightly. Once they were trapped in orbit, the larger star expanded and engulfed the smaller one. Once swallowed, the smaller star continued to orbit within the larger one, which eventually led to the larger star rotating so fast that its mass was spun outwards, creating the nebula. The bright spots that we see around the ring making this nebula appear like a necklace are actually the locations of dense clumps of gas. Four-filter fusion. In this next image, we are looking at the galaxy named NCG 7329, located 149 million light-years away, residing in the constellation of Tucana. Astronomers have observed that galaxies come in many shapes and sizes. This one happens to be a spiral galaxy, which is the same type of galaxy as our own Milky Way. In spiral galaxies like this, the arms extend out into the universe, while closer to the center, they spiral inwards towards the center. In the center of these galaxies is a supermassive black hole whose gravitational pull helps hold this massive structure together. A flash of light. Now we are looking at a planetary nebula, Abel 78, which is 5,000 light years away from Earth, located in the constellation Cygnus, also known as the Swan. When stars with masses a bit bigger than our own Sun reach the end of their life and begin to collapse to form white, hot dwarf stars, they will throw off their outer layers of matter. This matter will spread and form an elaborate cloud of gas, which is what we see as a planetary nebula. This planetary nebula is an unusual type due to it being created by a so-called born-again star, which has led to the irregular shell and the filaments of light that are seen in this image. Cosmic silver lining. This image shows us the emissions from the nebula NGC 2313 more than 3,700 light-years away. It shows a bright star, V565, surrounded by four prominent diffraction spikes that make the star appear to be at the center of a cross. The silvery veil of gas and dust appears as a fan moving out from the nebula. On the right half of the emissions is tinted red due to it being obscured by a dense cloud of dust. A dangerous dance. We can see two interacting spiral galaxies in this image that are intertwined together. Their collective name is ARP91. This is taking place over 100 million light years away from us. These two galaxies are merging into one through galactic cannibalization, where the bigger galaxy will draw in the smaller galaxy. As the two galaxies merge, there will be violent events with collisions of stars and planets, as well as forces sending the stars and planets of each galaxy to be sent out into the void. The combination of two spiral galaxies is thought to lead to the creation of elliptical galaxies, which have an elliptical three-dimensional shape. These two galaxies will continue this dangerous dance, becoming one galaxy for hundreds of millions of years before they come to rest as a single galaxy. On clusters and constellations. This is an amazing picture, that shows thousands of stars in addition to the globular cluster ESO 520-21, which is a densely packed collection of stars. We can see it in the center of this image as a cluster with a roughly spherical shape. Images like this can be challenging to get due to the sheer amount of gas and dust that collects in the dense areas of the universe, absorbing much of the starlight in that area. This cluster of stars is near the center of the Milky Way in the constellation Ophiuchus. Interestingly, this constellation was one of the 4 dozen constellations that Egyptian astronomers had named by the 2nd century. One of a pair. This image here shows us the spiral galaxy known as NGC 1317 that lives within the constellation Fornax that sits over 50 million light years from us. The spiral arms are easily visible in this image within the debris cloud that makes up the outer layers of this galaxy. In the bottom of the galaxy, we can see a bright star with a cross diffraction pattern around it. This star is actually from our own galaxy, the Milky Way, and sits right in our view of this galaxy. To the left of this star, we can see an elongated red dot. This red dot is actually another galaxy that exists much further away than NGC 1317. This is just another example of how massive our universe really is, and objects that appear small may be massive galaxies that are just extremely far away. Astronomy in action. This next picture shows us the image of a Herbig Haro object called HH111, captured by Hubble. A Herbig Haro object is an object that forms when active new stars expel jets of fast-moving ionized gas that are extremely narrow. The ejected gas is so hot that its atoms have lost the bonds with their electrons, which in turn gives the gas a very large electric charge. Once these jets of charged gas collide with clouds of gas and dust that linger around newly formed stars, Herbig Haro objects are created. The energy from those collisions create these beautiful nebulous areas around the new star. An interstellar distributor. Here is another image of a planetary nebula. This one is named ESO 455-10 and lies within the constellation of Scorpius, the Scorpion. This nebula was created from the death of its parent star. During the death of the star, its remaining matter is blown out and scattered out into space, where it creates beautiful nebulae, like this one seen here. This nebula has taken on the shape of an oblate shell and is symmetrical due to its interaction with the local matter and radiation between the other stars. Nebulae like this are thought by astronomers to be the source for many of the heavier metal elements. Some of these heavier elements are created in the center of stars while they are still alive, while some are produced in the star's explosive death. Return to the Veil Nebula. Another of the most beautiful pictures taken by Hubble Telescope is this one of a gorgeous nebula known as the Veil Nebula, which is located about 2,100 light years away. This nebula lies within the constellation of Cygnus, which is also known as the Swan. We can now see how the ionized gas spreads out in the delicate threads and filaments in this image. These threads and filaments that make up the nebula are primarily a type of ionized oxygen that shows up as blue in the image, as well as ionized nitrogen that shows up red here. This nebula was formed around 10,000 years ago after the death of a massive star. The parent star to this nebula was roughly 20 times the mass of our Sun and ended its life in a supernova event. Even one of the most destructive events in the universe can lead to the creation of some of the most beautiful objects in the universe. The Hubble Space Telescope has given us some of the most iconic images of space that help define our place in the universe. Even 31 years after its launch, it still produces breathtaking and awe-inspiring images. Although the Hubble Telescope may be reaching the end of its life in space, NASA is going to send a new telescope to replace it and hopefully give us a deeper, more detailed look at the universe that we all live in. If you watched all the way to the end, we want to say thank you for watching. And if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to hit the like and subscribe buttons so you won't miss any of our future videos.